gentlemen. Welcome. I'm Chris Gabrin. I am the principal of Murphy Creek, Pete through 8. Please stay seated while our 8th graders process their seats.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Welcome, students, parents, families, and friends, and the staff to our 2024 celebration as we celebrate the accomplishments of the graduating class for 2028. I'd like to thank our Berkeley Creek staff, Major Robert Liberley, who brought out the JORTC, and our distinguished guest who came out. It is an honor to introduce our eighth graders who will present the final words to the eighth grade class and their speeches around the theme of PBIS acronym JETS. Please welcome Joseph Higgins, Austin James, Michelle Ade, Kai Tesoro, Addison Jolly, and Cassandra Eli Melata.
Welcome everyone to the 2024 class of 2028 8th grade continuation. My name is Joseph Higgins, and I'm effervescent to have all of you here tonight. I've been at the school since kindergarten, and so I've been able to not just what makes the school special, but the community as well. The biggest reason our community here is so paradisical isn't just because of the magnate-like qualities of our staff, but because of JETS behavior. They go as follows. J, join in. E, excel. T, thoughtful actions. And S, self-respect. JETS behavior is able to ensure that our school is the perfect place for learning. And the words of our founding fathers from the Federalist Papers when speaking about the new Constitution, I venture some further and hesitate not to affirm that if the manner did not be perfect, it is at least excellent. It unites an eminent degree of all the advantages. Basically, JETS behavior is the best available way to keep our school civil and safe. This excerpt also shows how JETS behavior brings everyone together. Something that is part of the S, self-respect, in JETS behavior, is doing the right thing even though no one is watching or will know. I think this really applies to all JETS behavior, because it isn't just what you do in front of the crowd that matters, but it's what the little things that you do also matter. One experience that really demonstrated JETS behavior was theater for me. This is because so many people were able to show JETS behavior and just a pat on the back after auditions or asking how my rehearsals went. Other people in my life, not just those at Murphy, showed JETS behavior when they would ask about these things. Even though they didn't understand about blocking or dressing rehearsals, they would still take the time out of their day to ask about my life. And this really made all the difference. We can find JETS behavior every day if we are willing to look to the little things. Your family making a meal, taking their time to prepare it, not just for themselves, but for everybody. Something as simple as daily as that shows JETS behavior. Someone in your home doing the laundry, or the dishes, or any other household chore. All of these things show that they respect not just themselves, but the environment that they are in. Even something so regular as watering the plants can show JETS behavior. All of these small things culminate to have a large impact that may go unnoticed. But even if no one else knows it, they are demonstrating the most important part of JETS behavior. Doing the right thing for yourself and others, even and especially when it goes unnoticed. Watering a plant is a little thing, yet it is indispensable when it comes to the plant's growth. These little things are what allows it to grow, flourish, and mature. Someone who can really exhibit the J in JETS behavior and know what it means to join in is Austin James, our next speaker. Thank you all for having me.
Good evening. Good evening. I am Austin James, and today I'm excited to talk to you about one of the core values that make our school an extraordinary place. I have been here since kindergarten, and experienced these values firsthand, especially joining in. Joining in can be scary. I mean, have you ever been afraid of asking to join in when you see others playing? Are you ever scared to do something as simple as raise your hand in class for fear of answering wrong? As you all know, each letter in our school's name stands for a principle we hold dear. The J in JETS stands for joining in. And I believe it's the first step towards achieving not just success in school, but also in life. To join in means to participate, to become part of something, to engage with others, and to contribute to a group. One time, I wanted to go to the park and play basketball, but all of the hoops were full, with different people playing it then. So I was left with nowhere to play. So I asked my friend if I could play on his basketball hoop, and he said yes. So I walked over to his house, and we played. And then I asked him to lower the hoop, and I ended up messing around and dunked on him. But after, I lifted him up and helped him dunk, so he didn't feel left out. Joining can be something as simple as this, and doesn't have to always be something big. It can be such a small action. But joining in is also about taking a step forward and raising your hand and saying, I'm here, and I want to be involved. It means being an active member of our school community, whether that's by joining a club, playing a sport, or being part of a school project. But why is joining in so important? For starters, it helps us grow as individuals. When we join in, we learn new skills, we discover our passions, and we push our limits. We also learn about teamwork, leadership, and communication, all essential skills for our future. Also, joining in creates a sense of belonging. It connects us to others and helps us build friendships and memories that can last a lifetime. And it helps us build friendship. It's about being part of a team, where everyone has a role to play and every contribution is valued. It's about knowing that you are not alone and that you are part of something bigger than yourself. At Murphy Creek, we have countless opportunities to join in. We have clubs that cater to a wide range of interests, from science to art to drama. We have sports teams that welcome players of all abilities. And we have community service projects that allow us to give back to the community and make a difference. But joining in isn't always easy. It takes courage to step out of your comfort zone. It might mean trying something new, something you've never done before. It can mean risking failure or facing rejection. But let me tell you, the rewards are worth it. When you join in, you open the door to new experiences. You learn that failure is just a stepping stone to success, and that every time you try, you get stronger and more confident than you were a minute before. So I challenge each of you to join in, find something that interests you, and give it a shot. Start a conversation with someone new, volunteer for a project, try out for a team. Remember, every great journey starts with a single step, and that step is yours to take. As we finish up our middle school journey and move on to our high school years, let's make joining in more than just a letter in our school's acronym. Let's make it a way of life. Let's make our high schools, and maybe one day our colleges, not just a place, but a community, where everyone is welcome, where everyone has a place, and everyone can thrive. Thank you for listening, and remember, the J and Jets stands for us, all of us joining in together, building a place we can all be proud of, even after we have moved on. So carry on and keep joining in. Thank you for showing your support tonight. Now please welcome Michelle Adey, who will be speaking to you all about what it means to excel.
Thank you, Austin, for that amazing and powerful speech on joining in. I also want to thank the parents, principals, and teachers, and many others for being here to celebrate with us students today. My name is Michelle Adet, and today I will be speaking to you about the topic Excel and what it means to excel. What do you picture in your mind when you think about how to excel and how it could affect your own future? Well, when people think about Excel, they always think of others doing too much or caring too much about their grades and always wanting to do the best. Yes, even though sometimes that may be true, excelling goes way above and beyond than the assumptions that are brought up. First, allow me to give you the dictionary definition of the word Excel. Excel means to be exceptionally good at or proficient in an activity or subject. This is true to some occasions when it comes to excelling. However, I have my own definition towards the word excel. When I think of excelling or to excel, I think of being determined in order to succeed in all subjects or your future. For example, let's say you're taking a test. Would you rather have an A or a B? Having a B is not bad, but that's the thing about excelling. You would be the one working hard in order to get that A every time. That's the thing about the dedication of training yourself to better. Let me be clear, excelling isn't always easy, and it takes practice, time, and drive. I say this because I am not always perfect myself too. There will be days and times where I get lazy and wanting to finish my work, complain about the work being too much, and just the stress being over the rooftop. And because of this, I would have to think to myself about the future and how if I finish the stress, then all that stress would go away. That doesn't just mean I would rush and want to be done and finish without caring, of course. But instead, I do my work, give it my all, double-check my work, and finish it determined that I'll get that A. Excelling at anything doesn't always have to be academics, but it can also be in sports. Here over at Murphy, we have a lot of students that participate in sports. It doesn't matter whether it's volleyball, basketball, swimming, wrestling, soccer, etc. You can excel in whatever you love and enjoy doing the most. I wasn't always good at sports, and to be quite frank, I have never played a sport until I came over at Murphy Creek. My first time playing all sports was rough and hard, but the only way I was able to get through it was by persevering through those hard times and actually trying. Excelling in sports doesn't mean you have to be naturally good at it and amazing at that sport, but instead it's where you work hard and do your best at practice every day to get yourself to be perfect and the best. And because of this, this will make you ready to do sports in the future, since you already know what to achieve. Remember that in order to excel in anything, you will need help. Excelling is very hard to do on your own, because in order to succeed in anything, you also need someone to lift you up. For example, that can be your parents, teachers, coaches, and anyone depending on what you want to exceed. Don't be afraid to ask for help, and most importantly, don't be afraid to do your best. All these things matter because that's the start of being able to excel in all categories. So, take those for account, so in the future, you can get to that start point. Now, since we're getting towards the end of speaking on the topic Excel, please consider excelling for the future. I say this because we are starting to become freshmen in different schools and settings. To add on, we will eventually start a new life over there. Everything will be different, and that's when stuff will start to be important and even more challenging. Remember to always ask for help, do your best when things get tough, persevere, and go above and beyond. Excelling is something you will want to do. No one else will make you excel if you won't budge. Therefore, never say that you can't or you will not, but instead say I can and I will. Thank you all for being able to listen to my speech. Please give it up for Kai, who will discuss thoughtful actions.
Thank you, Michelle, for the inspiring words. I would like to extend my gratitude to everyone in attendance. My name is Kai Tessero, and I will be talking about thoughtful actions. Thoughtful actions can mean a lot of different things to different people. To me, thoughtful actions means having empathy and care for the people you love. I've been at Murphy Creek for a long time, and I've seen how these students treat their friends and others respectfully. I've seen the happiness on little kids' faces when older kids are kind to them. The little ones look up to us and aspire to be like us. When we do nice things, we put smiles on other people's faces. I experienced being a new kid long ago, and the thought of alone, being alone went across my mind. That being said, the longer I've been at Murphy Creek, the more and more friends I've gained. These friendships push me to try new things inside and outside of school. People you care about, like your friends or family, love you because of your personality and your actions. Now think about how you treat others and how that affects how they treat you. Also consider what your friends like about you and what you've done for them. People will treat you with kindness and empathy if you do the same for them. As we continue on the path of life into high school, onto college, and even as an adult, there will be plenty of times when thoughtful actions are used, like making new friends or taking care of your family. Every high five and hello to giving gifts, cooking dinner, are all acts of kindness. These acts are not very big, but they can be meaningful. Being kind isn't the only part of thoughtful actions. Being forgiving can be a big part too. In life, we all make mistakes, which is a driving factor of learning. But these mistakes, we need to learn how to forgive others and ourselves. If we keep grudges, we won't be able to live our lives to the fullest with these holy respect. When we forgive others, we can learn how to forgive ourselves, and we won't hold on to things that might ruin our lives. Forgiving can help preserve friendships that are dear to us. Grudges can make a divide between us and our families. This divide can scar relationships for years to come. That's why we should make amends and apologize. Showing kindness can be a big part of someone's life, and being kind should never go away. We need to take these thoughtful actions and apply them every single day. Doesn't matter what you do in life, kindness will always be there. Thank you very much for your time. I'm privileged to share my words with you today. I'm Kai Tessero on thoughtful actions, and please welcome Abby Dolly on self-respect.
Thanks, Kai, for the wonderful speech. Good evening, everybody. If you're unaware, my name is Addison Jollett, and I've been appointed to speak to you about self-respect. Most people know a condensed definition of respect. To sum it up, respect means demonstrating a level of admiration for someone or something. So respect is very similar. It's about showing a level of admiration for yourself. I'm here to inform you about how the 9 years, kindergarten through eighth grade, that I attended Murphy Creek has changed my perception of self-respect altogether. I've learned to presume that a fragment of self-respect is about accepting who you are. Accepting who you are can be many different things, such as accepting how you perform, not beating yourself up for making a mistake, and being okay with not being perfect. In different places where we spend a lot of time or may get stimulated, it can be hard to stay positive. When things get hard, the adults around us indeed hold some, not all of us, to high standards, which can make us look down on ourselves if we are not achieving those set standards. That's where self-respect comes into play. When you respect yourself and the work that you put into things, it makes tasks that once seemed very difficult not too hard to reach. This level of self-respect also can keep you from having the urge to cut corners or even cheat on an assignment or task that given to you. Sports are another great example. Things that fill up our spare time can also stimulate people into a spiral of disrespect to yourself. When you attend a sports game, meet, conference, etc., it can cause the athlete to have a lot of pressure again. That, again, is where self-respect comes into play. Little affirmations such as, I can do this, are not only respecting your strengths, but are also proven to make you work better and harder. To me, self-respect is about accepting yourself and staying true to your values. This fragment of self-respect leads me to think of a story with a man my mom went to school. His name was Alex Oshkianski. He was bullied throughout his school years for being quote-unquote weird. The best thing about it was he was not embarrassed of himself. He didn't try to hide his personality from people, but rather announced it. Even though he was quote-unquote weird, he was smart and happy with who he was. That is one of the important things that come with self-respect. He graduated high school with his associate's degree and only had to do 1 year in college to get his bachelor's. He went through med school and became a radiologist. The interesting yet very helpful thing to his future was he decided to go to law school in the middle of med school because he was bored. After he finished med school and his internship at Harvard Medical School, Brigham and Women's Hospital, and Johns Hopkins Medical School, he found that patients he was treating who had cancer found it hard to pay for medicine. That's when he came up with the idea for Mark Cuban cost plus drug. He wanted to make affordable cancer treatments, insulin, and etc. But Alex couldn't do that all on his own. That's when he had an idea. He sent a cold email to Mark Cuban to fund his idea. And it worked. Mark Cuban agreed to help Alex with this next step, which also made it the first time that Mark Cuban used his name when funding a company. Alex Oshkianski has changed history more than any of the people who bullied him ever would have, all because he respected who he was and embraced who he was. A great example of self-respect that can help take people. Self-respect is not all about being okay with who you are, but also about advocating for yourself. When we get stimulated in certain environments, it can be easy just to let things happen to you. But life, you don't want people throwing you around. You need to stand your ground, be aware of your strengths and weaknesses, and work with the people around you to make adjustments to accommodate those strengths and weaknesses so you can be the best version of yourself. During the school year, I had an unannounced condition for that. Now, I had been super flexible and double jointed all my life, and it didn't seem to be an issue until it escalated. And I was able to plot differently inside myself. When things like that happen, you have to take a step to fix it. So I did physical therapy to strengthen my joints. But more ligaments were able to pop out, so we decided to take it to more than just my pediatrician. The only time I was able to get my physical therapy appointments and meeting new doctors and writing tests was in the school year. So that means I had to miss school, whether that was leaving early or coming late, or even missing a full day. I worked so hard in school to get where I am, but I don't want to fall off behind. So I advocated for myself and reached out to my teachers to give them a rundown of what was happening. I was standing my ground, working with my teachers to make accommodations as needed. At one point, I was able to film an experiment so I knew what class was talking about the next day. I respect myself and work with my teachers so I can work through this endeavor and still perform the way I'm capable. In the 9 years I've attended Murphy Creek, I have learned the different branches of self-respect and how it impacts my education in my everyday life. I've learned to accept my worth and how it performs in class. I've also learned the importance of advocating for my education. Take a moment to digest this song. Self-respect, admiring who you are in life, is an important thing to have. A step in the right direction to be successful. What does that mean to you? Thank you for your time tonight. Please welcome Cassandra Olaimaliota.
For your reflection of self-respect, a quality that truly defines us as individuals and as a community. Talofa and aloha. My name is Cassandra Olaimaliota, or Cassie for short, and standing here before you today is a moment I never would have imagined, sharing my journey from uncertainty to strength. I relocated from Hawaii just last school year, and I was hesitant to come to Colorado because I've never experienced what it would feel like living in a different state for the first time. I faced uncertainty about this new chapter of my life and thought of starting anew, particularly at a new school known as Murphy Creek seemed daunting at first. But here I am, standing before you, delivering a speech about the impact Murphy Creek has had on me. Murphy Creek, once an intimidating prospect, has become a cherished part of my journey. Shout out to my parents in the Army for getting it right. When I was given the opportunity to deliver the speech, I was excited, but I soon realized that finding the right words to say would be challenging, and such feelings are a natural part of life's journey. I'm just a teenager who has no idea what obstacles I'll face, and the best one yet was relocating to Colorado. I was afraid of the challenge, but I realized that the key to success lies in taking that first step, despite our fears and doubts. The most valuable lesson Murphy Creek has taught me that I've come to appreciate is to stop overthinking and just go for it. This phrase was frequently said to my peers and I during classes and sports. Overthinking can paralyze us, but Murphy Creek has taught me the power of perseverance and the importance of pushing forward, no matter the obstacles. Many teenagers like myself face the same struggle of overthinking, self-doubt, and fear. It can be challenging to find the motivation to pursue something when you don't believe in yourself. This is how I felt when I first moved here, scared of the unknown and what the future held for me. I thought I couldn't handle a new school environment, make new friends, or try out for sports I had never even played before. I kept telling myself that I didn't belong here, even before I went to my first day of school. I kept telling myself that I couldn't let that stop me, because I've always had the drive to be successful growing up, and it didn't matter if it meant being athletic, smart, or inspiring. I just knew I wanted to succeed. I learned the power of perseverance and the importance of embracing challenges are stepping stones to success. Life has its ups and downs, but we must keep pushing forward and never give up no matter what. I was introduced to multiple sports at Murphy Creek that I had little to no experience in, such as volleyball, soccer, basketball, wrestling, and swimming. Joining in was my first step. Some of you may remember me from the volleyball court, but believe it or not, I played my very first official volleyball game here at the home of the Jets. The supportive community at Murphy Creek encouraged and made me feel like a part of the team. It's easy to doubt ourselves in the face of challenges, but we must remember that joining with others and experiencing obstacles is essential to achieving our goals. Whether it's missing a shot, getting a volleyball out, or not running fast enough, it's all just a work in progress. And learning from mistakes only means more progress, not failure. Although playing sports meant I had to keep up with my grades, I wasn't always a top-performing student. I've had my fair share of stress and procrastination, yet these experiences have taught me the value of resilience. Rather than giving in to self-doubt, I've learned to approach challenges with a growth mindset, understanding that setbacks are opportunities for growth. So remember to get your work done, turn it in, and don't be afraid to make mistakes. Like Mr. Harbison once told me, just turn it in and stop overthinking it. We must embrace criticism and learn from mistakes in order to succeed in the next step. As an island girl who was once scared to leave home, to achieve goals that I never thought would be possible in a new state, such as winning the city championship for volleyball, securing first place in the city championship for shot put, and being recognized as a female athlete of the year, are testaments to the power of self-belief, determination, and humility. As we journey on to high school, I want to remind my classmates and anyone facing uncertainty that it's okay to be scared of the unknown, and don't let anything stop you from pursuing your dreams. With the right mindset and attitude, you're capable of achieving anything you set your mind to, with hard work and determination. If you're constantly overthinking or run into an obstacle, always remember our Jets motto. Join in and experience new things with confidence. Excel and push through with faith. Think twice about our actions and how they affect us, and most importantly, respect and believe yourselves. In closing, on behalf of our 8th grade class, I extend our gratitude to the Murphy Creek teachers and staff for fostering an environment for growth and empowerment. Thank you for your hard work and dedication in the early mornings and late nights. Thank you for your patience, kindness, and understanding that has helped us grow and succeed. And thank you for being great role models and mentors for us over the past years. We are grateful for all you have done for us, and may God bless you all. Mahalo and go Jets.
Tell they put a lot of work into those speeches, so thank you students for working so hard and presenting your thoughts to your classmates and virtuosos. Please come to the stage to perform Diamonds.
Shine bright like a diamond.
Beautiful.
these years of Murphy Creek and Aurora Public Schools. We'd like to honor you as students. Please stand up and thank your parents, grandparents, and guardians for everything about this summer. And also, congratulations to our elementary and middle school teachers, our counselors, our coaches, our sponsors, our support staff, who over the past few years have contributed to your success. And with the staff of the Murphy Creek Independence, please stand up to be recognized.
Gunnar Barnett. would like to thank Ms. Q for secretly giving him tickets at Winterfest. Addison Bell. Addison would like to thank Mrs. Cohen, Mr. Harbinson, Ms. Cooley, for always being people she could talk to, her parents for listening to her, and her friends for being there. Riley Burquist. Riley would like to thank Mr. Harbinson and Mr. Lazar because they've always been supportive. And not only have they done all of that, but they helped her become a better athlete. Giselle Cavallera. Giselle would like to thank her family, the Harbinsons, all the teachers who have been there for her, and her best friend for always pushing her to do her best. Ethan Carson. Ethan would like to thank Mr. Harbinson for teaching him and giving him lessons, not just in school, but in life. Adrian Casillas Medina. Adrian would like to thank his siblings for always pushing him to be his best and his parents for supporting him. Aaliyah Cheney Hunter. Aaliyah would like to thank God and her mom because they pushed her when she felt like giving up. Savannah Chetney. Savannah would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for all their support during highs and lows. Micah Clark. Micah would like to thank Mr. Harbinson and Ms. Polk for pushing him to where he is today. Austin Cleveland. Austin would like to thank Mr. Milner for always helping him, Mr. Harbinson for challenging him, and his wrestling coach, Mr. Robinson, for believing in him. Isaiah Clint. Isaiah would like to thank his family, his teachers, and himself. Axel Coronado Saavedra. Axel would like to thank his friends because they worked their way through middle school and he wishes them the best in high school. Coraline Crabtree. Coraline would like to thank her parents for always supporting her, her friends for being there, and her teachers for being able to teach her even when she had trouble. Elijah Derajay. Elijah would like to thank his teachers and his parents.
Aldana Desta. Aldana would like to thank her family for helping her through the hard times. Alisson Diallo. Alisson would like to thank both of his parents for pushing him and making him work hard. Evan Drinker. Evan would like to thank his family and coaches for helping him get to where he is today and helping him become someone he can be proud of. Yodahe Dulo. Yodahe would like to thank his teachers for all they taught him for the life and for the life lessons along the way. Nedu Ashatan. Nedu would like to thank his seventh grade teachers and his friends for making him who he is today. Jamari Eugene. Jamari would like to thank his family for helping him to achieve his goals for the year. Kyrie Finley. Kyrie would like to thank all of her 8th grade teachers for giving her the best possible preparations for freshman year. Kevin Franklin. Kevin would like to thank this lineman for always making his day up. Caleb Getachew. Caleb would like to thank his family and friends for helping him through the school year. Shannon Henry. Previous teachers, Ms. Cohen, the Harbinsons, Mr. Lassard, Ms. Roth, Ms. McGrain, Ms. Burkhan, Ms. Solomon, Ms. Walker, and Ms. Strands for making her years at Perfect Green the best. Arielle Hernandez. Arielle, her sister, and her mom for always being there and supporting her, being role models, and helping her to achieve her best and never give up. Joseph Higgins. Joseph Higgins. Teachers for all their degrees. staff for how they supported him and influenced him into becoming his best self. I cannot thank you guys enough. Addison Miller. Addison, we'd like to thank her parents for always being there for her, Mr. Harbison for clearing her in volleyball, and Bella for supporting her through 7th and 8th grade. Keldrick Hines. Keldrick, we'd like to thank his parents, teachers, and friends for helping him persevere and succeed throughout 8th grade. Jasmine Hollingsworth. Jasmine, we'd like to thank her family and teachers. Jamari Hollowell Turner. Jamari, I want to see you motivation to keep pushing through. Lucy Hovland. Lucy would like to thank her mom and dad for helping her through everything, especially when things got hard. Jalen Jackson. As well, and his cousin Corey is always being there facing him about him. Austin James. Austin would like to thank his parents, siblings, friends, and teachers, specifically Ms. Burkine, Ms. Amanda, Mr. Lassard, and Mr. McCurdy, for always supporting him and helping me grow in athletics, arts, and academics, and as a better person. Zakiya Johnson. Keep her head up when she felt as if she couldn't accomplish anything more. Addison Young. Addison would like to thank the teachers, especially Ms. Burkine. She has built a connection for this lesson from kindergarten through now.
Avery Kelly. Avery would like to thank his friends for supporting him, Mr. Wright for helping him prepare for high school, and his parents for teaching him about gratitude and helping others. Jasmine Knight. Jasmine would like to thank herself because she's made it through school. Trey John Lawrence. Trey John would like to thank Ms. Ashley for being a great teacher, Mr. Hawkinson for all the great stories, Mr. Lassard for making gym and sports fun, and Mrs. Albers, even though she no longer works here, Trajan wants to thank her for being a great kindergarten teacher. Genesis Leobanos. Genesis would like to thank Mr. Hartson, Mr. Lassard, and her mom, because they all taught her so much about never give up and accomplish her dreams. Nia Martin. Nia would like to thank all her friends and her family because they've been there for her throughout the whole school year and have done so much that she really appreciates. Jaslyn Mendez. Jaslyn would like to thank her parents and coaches for pushing her and being the best she can. Jocelyn Mendoza. Jocelyn would like to thank her parents and her siblings. Jaylene Milan Guerra. Jaylene would like to thank her mom because of all that she's taught her and how never to give up. She'd like to thank her older sister, Jasmine, for pushing her to go the right way and encouraging her to think positively. And she would like to thank Mrs. Naeli and Ms. Myrna for everything they've done for her this year. Kinger Noguera Vega. Kinger would like to thank his parents for always being there and being the best. Dylan Ofori Kuragu. Dylan would like to thank God, Mr. Lassard for being supportive, and Mr. Patch. Ella Ullman. Ella would like to thank her parents, friends, and all the previous teachers, especially Mrs. Coleman, the Harkinsons, Mr. Lassard, Mrs. Higgins, Mrs. Q, and Mrs. Henry. Thank you for making her years in Murphy Creek the best they could be. Micah Phillips. Micah would like to thank his friends and his parents. Manuel Paulson. Manuel would like to thank Mrs. Sasita McCormick for being kind and helping him with his homework and his learning. Jefferson Kish Florian. Jefferson would like to thank his mother and his father for their kindness. Tyler Remy. Tyler would like to thank his family for raising him to be a decent human being. Monica Richardson. Monica would like to thank Mr. Harbinson for his mid-class rants. He gave lots of wise advice, not only for their future, for their school future, but also for jobs and relationships, etc. Briogeny Riley. Briogeny would like to thank her older brother, Brinshaw, for inspiring her and being a great friend when needed. Lucas Rivera. Lucas would like to thank his mom and dad because they are the reason he's here today. Alexa Rodriguez Gonzalez. Alexa would like to thank each and every single one of her teachers for pushing her and for being ready to be ready for high school. And she would also like to thank her mom for pushing her to be a better person in every possible way. Jaden Rodriguez Soria. Jaden would like to thank his mom for supporting him over the years, and the ELD teachers and sixth grade teachers. Miabella Rodriguez. Miabella would like to thank Mrs. Gagnon for always having her door open and allowing her and her friends to come over whenever they wanted to take a break from class or just to distract themselves and talk with her.
Aria Rogers. Aria would like to thank her older sister for understanding her, her mom for providing for her, and her dad for struggling and teaching her the right thing. Peyton Rowley. Peyton would like to thank both Mr. Lassard and Mr. Harbison for helping her with sports and life. They are two of the many teachers that she will miss when leaving for high school. Xavion Sanchez. Xavion would like to thank Mr. Wright for helping him learn from the past, what he should do in the future, and not rewriting the mistakes. Kieran Schroeder. Kieran would like to thank his friend for making school tolerable, God for gifting him with his abilities, and Mr. Patterson for being so supportive. Matthew Seleschi. Matthew would like to thank his teachers because they taught him a lot of good lessons. Peyton Chu. Peyton would like to thank her mom and stepdad and friends for always being there for her. Riley Smith. Riley would like to thank Tyler, Peyton Chu, Monica Richardson, and Coraline Crabtree for always being there. Cisse Sumbundu. Cisse would like to thank her family for helping her through all the hard times. Kai Tercero. Kai would like to thank his friends, family, and all of Murphy Creek for being there by my side for my journey throughout this amazing school. I'm proud to call myself a gem. Caitlin Thatch. Caitlin would like to thank Mrs. Jones because she made me understand my mistakes, not ridicule me, even if I was being unbearable. Jake Tim. Jake Tim would like to thank Ms. Q, God, and his parents for helping him. Dakota Tintori. Takuda would like to thank his parents and step-parents for encouraging him to get to where he is today. Arishton Valencia. Arishton would like to thank his family for pushing him to do better and his friends for making the school year fun. Abby Barner. Abby would like to thank her parents, her brother Zach, and Blythe Young for always being there for me, Mr. Harbison and Mrs. Cole. Camilla B. Hill. Camilla would like to thank Ms. Cooler, aka Ms. Cooley, Mr. Wright, and Ms. Villasard for being the best teachers, her parents for dragging her around all the time, and herself for persevering. Royal Wilson. Royal would like to thank her parents for getting her through the school year and pushing her forwards. Jaden Warren. Jaden would like to thank his family because they got him here. Angel Willis. Angel would like to thank her friends because they have helped her through a lot and made her laugh when she was upset. Trenton Wolcotti. Trenton would like to give thanks to God, all his friends, and many of my teachers throughout the years, but most important, my family for believing in me. Venus Zhao. Venus would like to thank her family, friends, teachers, and coaches for supporting her.
Congratulations to the class of 2028. It is my pleasure to introduce Assistant Principal Ms. Deborah Butler with our 8th grade special recognitions.
Good evening. Okay, now's the time you can really clap for that. So, we have a bunch of people here tonight who have shown us some things. And so we're grateful to them, grateful to you for what you have done for them along the way. So if you come here tonight, you've applauded them. And I want you to recognize that those here tonight that are applauding you will be your biggest supporters, your biggest encouragers, and your biggest backers for the rest of your life. I want you to understand that the applause that you get tonight will be what's lifting you as you go forward. Andre Agassi said that he would tell his people that those applaud him in those moments, and those that applaud them in those moments, would soon fall away. And those peers and those that love them the most will be the ones that stay there. So I tell you tonight, these are the ones that will be there for you. As part of our honoring tonight, we're going to honor our students here tonight because this is the time for us to honor them for the things that they've done at Murphy Creek since they've been here. So as I call out the events, the clubs, the different things that you've been in, I ask that you stand and I ask that you hold your applause until that group has finished standing. So if you've been on any sports team here at Murphy Creek, please stand. That includes track, swimming, wrestling, volleyball, and soccer. Please give them a hand. You may be seated. If you have been a member of Virtuoso at any time, please stand. Jets ambassadors at any point, please stand. If you at any time at Mercy Creek have been Student of the Month, please stand. You may be seated. If you have been named an Aurora Scholar, please stand. You may be seated. If you were a member of the DC Trip Group, please stand. You may be seated. If you have been a member of Honor Choir, please stand. You may be seated. If you had an exhibit in the art show, please stand. At this time, we will have roll call. If you started at Murphy Creek in kindergarten, please stand and remain standing. If you joined our family in first grade, please stand. If you joined us in second grade, you may stand. If you join the family in third grade, please stand. If you join us in fourth grade, please stand. If you joined our family in fifth grade, please stand. If you joined us in sixth grade, please stand. And those that joined us in seventh grade, you can stand. And those last members of our family joining us this year, eighth grade, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the class of 2028. Now it is your time to step up. Step up to the challenges you'll face. Now it's your time to move on. Move on to the next chapter and write it well. I applaud you. We applaud you. You did it.
Please welcome to the podium Ms. Myrna Perez Gonzalez. She is the Vice President of the Murphy Creek PTO. In April of 2014, Murphy Creek lost an amazing person, our counselor, Ms. Sherry Hill. That year, students, staff, and Murphy Creek community and our amazing PTO came together to honor the legacy of Ms. Hill by organizing the Sherry Hill Legacy Scholarship. Ms. Hill focused on academic success for all students. She was consistently encouraging them to set goals in high school and beyond.
The Sherry Hill Scholarship of $1,000 each is awarded to two eighth graders, grade students who seek to attend a post-secondary institution upon graduating from high school. This spring, we had an incredibly challenging task of selecting only two students. All the applicants were well-written, thoughtful, and exhibited the traits of individuals who are going to go far in life. A committee of parents, staff members, read through each scholarship application blindly. The committee did not know who the students were initially.
but based scoring solely on each applicant's answers to the applicant's questions. There were amazing answers for each applicant. When we announce this year's scholarship recipients, please come forward. Our first scholarship recipient explains how her experience with being on Girls on the Run helped her grow self-confidence and self-love and proved to her that she could overcome hard challenges. Her positive experience led her to volunteer as an assistant coach and led her to share her growth story with Murphy Creek's young runners. She felt it is important to be a part of bettering the lives of each young girl as well as the community as a whole. She is grateful to be able to help teach these girls how to make a positive change in the community and how to nurture their own self-love and confidence. Her goal after high school is to study mathematics in college and then work in a career that solves complex global problems and makes life better for the Earth and its 8 billion inhabitants. Congratulations to our first Sherry Hill Legacy Scholarship, Shannon Henry.
Experience and his desire to help others. He shared how he took on the responsibility to support and ensure that his teammates did their best on and off the court. Not only did he help them with learning the plays, but he also tutored them in order to maintain eligibility. Encouraging them during challenging moments on and off the court, he hopes to better the world by giving young children what they learn to become a kind person that the world needs more of. He tries to connect with younger students at Murphy Creek by giving them a hug when it's cold, a snack after a long day, a high five, or other rewards by doing good in class. After high school, the student plans to study forestry because not only does it help to protect trees, but it also is a big part of the lumber industry. Forestry isn't just beneficial to our current world, it is a necessity of the future. Congratulations to our Sherry Hill Legacy Scholarship recipient, Joseph Higgins. Thank you for everyone for celebrating this evening. I'd also like to give a special thanks to Miss Blair, who has spent hours and hours putting together the presentation we're about to see. Miss Liza George, she has prepped our virtuosos, they did a beautiful job today. Also, Miss Moore, who just runs everything around here, make sure everything's set for us. The eighth grade team, Miss Cooley, Mr. Milner, Patterson, right? They spent so much time getting them prepped for this event. And as you can see, they did a great job during this event. Ms. Butler and our custodial staff, Mr. Davidson, they were amazing. Just setting this all up, it takes a huge team to get this going. So please give them a round of applause. Alright, so this is where the transformation kind of happens. So Ms. Blair has prepared this video for us to view, and our 8th graders, will you please walk carefully to the seats? We have not practiced this. We'll see what this looks like. So after viewing the video, please join us in the cafeteria for the reception. Thank you for coming.
I'm lost. Congratulations. Graduation. Yeah. I pick up the rock and I ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But right now I got a situation. Never old being Franklin. Cash. Big rings, champagne. My life is like a ball game. But instead I'm in a trap, though. Paso big, call it Super Bowl. Super Bowl, caught up. Get in the rolls. Top flow lifestyle. Huncho and Post. Malone. I got a play on my phone. You know what I'm on. Huncho Houdini is gone.
My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset done changed. Ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation.